Hello everyone and welcome to Cynical Car Guy, presented by Memos, makers of Stuff for Car Guys. Today we are having a look at my E39. So we own this car now for over half a year, nearly three quarters of a year actually. And some small niggly problems are starting to show up. First of all, we just came back from our weekend in Spa-Francorchamps, where we drove the Cadillac ATS-V on the circuit. And some vandals have visited our shop and demolished the little valve in one of the tires. So I came back and one of the tires was completely deflated. I took it to the shop and they said that the valve had been destroyed. But luckily they did replace it for free. Very nice guys. So I came back, I put the spare tire on in the meantime and went to start the car to drive away. And we had a small, nearly small oil fire on the exhaust. There was a lot of smoke. And so it's really time now to replace our gasket. So due to the size of this immense six-cylinder engine, it has been slanted a bit to fit under the hood line. And because of the length of the block, the gaskets tend to wear out quicker. There are heat cycles, there's a lot of heat at the end of the block, and so they do wear out quicker. And if you feel under the valve cover, as you can see, the valve cover gasket is no longer sealing. And that, because it's slanted like I explained, that then leaks onto the exhaust manifold, which is right under there. And so when you go to start the car and it has been standing for a bit, some of the oil leaked onto the manifold, you will have smoke bellowing out from everywhere. It came through the kidney grills, out from the fenders, and from under the hood towards the window. So yeah, that's not ideal. So that has been ordered, and in fact I have also ordered all the stuff to do the inspection, and we're gonna make a little how-to on how to do a complete BMW surface for under 100 bucks. So stay tuned for that. Other problems are, this is also a typical BMW thing of the 90s. This is the power steering fluid reservoir, as you can see, right? Running a little bit empty, and that is because this also tends to leak. There's this a hose on the bottom of it that tends to give way after time, and as you can see, that then seeps, and also I think our oil or our power steering rack itself is also leaking. So a few things to button up still here with the oil leakages. I already explained before that this is the typical BMW fault of the 90s. Everything starts to leak. And so ours has become a victim as well recently. Another mechanical fault that we have going on that also developed itself recently is, again, another typical BMW thing, which is the wheel bearings. Of course, on a car that is now 20 years old and has more than 200,000 kilometers, it is only to be expected, and I think should be taken into account for normal maintenance. But the wheel bearing has to be replaced. It's starting to make some noise when it's cold in the morning, and then once you drive a bit, it starts going away. So I think it's starting to show a little bit of excessive wear, and we're gonna have to replace it. And for anyone wondering why we didn't run the 19-inch wheels off our wheels and suspension episode for a while, it's because this happened. Just like I said in the video of putting them on, I said to be careful with these spacers. These are actually very high quality German made spacers. It's just the fact that the 19-inch wheels weigh a lot. And yeah, during some more spirited driving, these gave way. Then I put the 17s back on, except for this is of course the spare wheel, but I put the 17s that came with the car back on. I gave them a refinish in a dark gray to look nicer with our design, and I found that the car drove much nicer. The handling is much tighter, the suspension behaves better. The 19 inches were clearly too heavy. If I'll be going back to 19 inch, I'm so happy with the handling that I'm seriously doubting that. But if I'll go back to the 19 inch, it has to be something lightweight, or maybe 18 inch, It has to be something lightweight, and it has to be something that looks seriously a lot better than the styling 32s. On to the things that have annoyed me, that I want to modify still, but are not necessarily things that are mechanically wrong with the car. This will be a familiar thing to a lot of M52 engined BMW drivers, like the 328, 528, 728, etc, etc, also all the 23 models. Is that the sound is not really magnificent. I really like the fact that this is a very quiet car, but then when it does make some noise, for example when you go to overtake or you merge in on the highway and the engine does make some sound, it's not a particularly nice sound. It's a very high-pitched type of sound for the vehicle that it is, and engine before this, M50 and the M54 after this, have a much deeper, more bassy sound. So this is actually something that I would like to address. Again, I don't want to make it louder, I just want to make the sound nicer. So I think maybe the intake trajectory from the later models will fix this, or full exhaust from the M54 model, which is completely different than this. This particular M52 engined E39 has the restrictors and mufflers that take exhaust gases, but then they don't continue the flow, so they don't go in there and then they're trapped. And these are like noise cancellation mufflers where the sound can only go in but doesn't come out. And I think this makes the effect of it sounding so high pitched rather than the lower, deeper sound that the earlier or later models have. So that, in my opinion, was a lot nicer. I said already once before, I had three E36s before. They were all M50 models. I have a friend who has an M54 E39. They sound a lot nicer. The headlight. The headlight we have modified to be quad projector. Like I said before, I love the look. I really am happy with the outcome. But with the winter approaching now, it's getting darker sooner. Like I did say, I do live in the city, but if I'm out in the country and I need my main dips, it would be nice to have them actually fully functioning. So I think I will upgrade them as well to a bike xenon standalone projector, so that will actually work very nice, and it will improve the lighting output greatly. Next to that, I don't know if it's just me not understanding or being too stupid, but you can adjust these all you want, and then you put a car as flat as you can, you know, like you would when you're adjusting headlights. You take the correct distance and you mark everything out. You put them correctly, what you think is correctly, and you go out on a drive. The auto adjusters do this and that, and you come back and then they're either too high or too low. So these are a pain in the to adjust. Yeah, this takes a lot of time to get correct. Other things are basically cosmetic that I still want to upgrade or modify. The badges, I thought it would be nice to see where this car came from, you know, but they are starting to annoy me a little bit, being so worn out. And I must say, other than that, taking into consideration that this is a 20-year-old car with 200,000 kilometers, that is basically our whole list. That is everything that I think one or two cosmetics things still that need to be addressed, but that is it. And I really do think then it will be finished. Like I said, only a couple things to button up. I have said before that this car is for sale, but we only had test drive pilots up until now, unfortunately. So the project continues until we find the right buyer, and that's it. So stay tuned for the episode on doing a full BMW service under 100 bucks. And we're also going to tell you some tips and tricks to stay under that 100 bucks with this type of vehicle. And then also, thank you very much for watching. See you next week. Bye-bye.